What does family mean to you? I mean, does it have to be the people you're actually related to?
When you are close to people, they become family. Sometimes, whether you want them to or not.
Cute. I'm going to take that as a compliment. When I was working for Noctrayan, doing the pirate thief thing, he had a daughter my age, Risha. It wasn't like Noct was super sweet to her or anything. But he'd call her princess, and I wished I was her.
You've only spoken of a mother and sister. What happened to your father?
Dead, enslaved, disappeared. We never really knew. Maybe that's why I wanted to be Risha. Risha was smart and strong. She knew how to do everything around the ship. And I went everywhere with her. Suddenly I had a sister again. For years it was Risha and me against the galaxy and anyone who gave us grief.
Memories of the best times in life are treasures later in life.
Who are you and what did you do with the Sith I know? Eventually, Noct hatched some secret plan that I couldn't be a part of. One that apparently got them both killed. But for a while there, I really was happy. Enough of that.
My lord, I have been working on something in my spare time. You may be interested.
Go ahead, regale me.
Years ago, I was zeroing in on a notorious SIS agent called Volleran, when Moff Broisk recalled me to the Battle of Druckenwell. I had the spy cornered. I briefed Broisk so that he could send someone else to take Volleran out. He ignored the opportunity.
This Moff is starting to sound like a chronic screw-up.
That is not for me to determine. I will say this, though. Since then, Volleran has gone on to wreak havoc against the Empire. One missed opportunity has led to a decade of unnecessary losses. I know Volleran's signature. And by tracking his accomplishments, I've picked up his scent.
It is imperative that you track him down.
Very good, my lord. I'll keep you abreast of my progress.
The sands of Tatooine await you, apprentice. I've gleaned much since our interrogation of the Republic agent here on Dromund Kaas. I am certain Nomon Kaar brought this gifted Padawan to Tatooine to train with a legendary master named Yonlok. Years ago, I urged the Dark Council to hunt down and destroy this Jedi. They refused, and Yonlok went into hiding on Tatooine.
What should I do with him once I track him down?
Yonlok is the one who brought the Padawan's powers into expression. Now they share a special bond. Find him and destroy him.
Where do you suggest I begin?
My servant Sharok Biv will guide you. She's eccentric, an acquired taste. But give her the benefit of the doubt.
As you decree, my lord.
That is all.
The harsh sands of Tatooine welcome you. I am Sharok Reeve. Our lord and master Darth Barriss bid me to impart my knowledge of this planet and help you track down the Jedi Master Yonlok.
It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
I will be your compass. You will find Master Yonlok by tracing the path the Padawan and her master took. I can tell you where they started. I followed them to the forbidden lair of the ancient sand demon, a terrible beast. The Padawan left her weapons and entered alone. Impossibly, she returned unscathed.
She brought the Force. It is a powerful weapon.
I have witnessed the power of the Force, but this goes beyond wonder. The sand demon is the fiercest creature on this planet. You don't just walk into its lair and return without a scratch. I investigated further. The beast was there, also undamaged. And what's most perplexing, its skin was glistening.
That is very confusing. Was it bleeding?
Not blood as from a wound. More like the layer of living gel one is born into the world covered in. What happened in that cave is a mystery. as is where the Padawan and her master went afterwards. There is one man on Tatooine who might be able to explain. Isabeau Jeef. He's as old as the sand. Part madman, part soothsayer.
I want to talk with this man immediately.
It will not be easy to speak with Jeef. The small farming settlement where he lives has been overrun by Exchange thugs. The Exchange hates the Empire for running them out of Mos Eila. They will allow me to pass, but they'll attack you on sight.
Thanks for looking out for me.
I'm invested in seeing you succeed, and I will meet you at Isabeau Jeef's.
The world is weeping, and the tears evaporate in the heat of our sins.
I think you mean from the heat of our sons, Isabeau.
No, child. There is a dark presence newly arrived on Tatooine.
Ah, Sith. You made it. The hostiles outside were no match for you, I see.
They tried to stop me. They failed.
Failure can be contagious, and hard to dispel once contracted. You are the Seeker Sharak spoke of. You wish to understand the Jedi's purpose in the lair of the Sand Demon.
You see it correctly.
My eyes may be aged and failing, but my mind sees.
Please, Isabeau, make haste. Tell my friend what you know. I will remain here after to hear your wisdom.
Fine. Gather close. Few are aware that Tatooine was once a place of positive Force energy. Jedi made pilgrimages here to renew and purify. The sands speak of a ritual called the Demon's Blood. This is likely what the Jedi that Sharak witnessed was engaged in.
Explain this ritual.
The Demon's Blood. A Jedi seeking enlightenment would cover himself in fresh Sand Demon blood and enter the village of the Savage Ones. Cowering before the Demon Slayer, the Savage Ones would reveal the path to self-discovery and to that which the Slayer seeks.
Do you mean the Sand People?
Tatooine makes most who come here savage, and the Sand People have been here all along.
Isabeau, as I told you, the girl faced the beast but left it unwounded.
There must be another way to bathe in the beast's blood, but you'll have to discover that for yourself, if you care to. To know where this Jedi girl went, you'll have to perform the ritual yourself, and then see if the Savage Ones speak.
I appreciate your help and insights.
Step lightly on my desert. It has been through so much in its life.
Here are the coordinates you will need. After you face the Sand Demon, I will meet you at the Sand People compound. If the legend is true, and the Sand People have something to offer you, I wish to see it with my own eyes.
Can we talk for a second? I really don't have a good feeling about this.
I'll make you feel better later.
We're about to face a monster that can swallow us whole. I'm thinking, if the Jedi perform the Demon Blood ritual without a fight, there must be a way we can too. As a favor to me, could we please get through this without mixing it up with the Sand Demon?
I was already planning on doing that.
Oh good. That's a relief. Looks like it's showtime. The monster's caught a whiff of us. I'm ready to back you up if it goes badly.
Desert monster, I stand my ground. I will not run.
Look into my eyes, beast. I show my back to demonstrate my dominance. The beast has been cowed. easy prey, don't you?
Yuck! So much blood! If I knew we were gonna literally bathe in it, I would have waited outside. And the smell. Oh, Cag, we're gonna stink for days. What if it never wears off?
It will be all right, Fett.
I sure hope you're right. I take a lot of pride in my hygiene. So, let's get out of the stink pit, huh?
You took the words out of my mouth.
Lead the way.
I trailed and observed your descent here. I could not believe my eyes. The Sand People all ran from you. What transpired inside the Sand Demon Cave that makes this so?
It was an epic battle, and I killed the beast.
You have bathed in the demon's blood. Its essence fills the air. Now, Isabeau said that this is where your path will be illuminated. But there doesn't seem to be anything here. Wait! On your guard, Offworlder. One of the Sand People approaches.
I will respond in kind.
I've never seen one of the Sand People approach an outsider in peace. This parchment the Sand Person brought is remarkable. It is a crude but very clear map of the desert. It marks a door carved into the wall of the Desert Wound Ravine. But I've mapped this ravine, and there is no such door.
If this is where the Padawan went, I must follow.
I shudder to think what awaits you there. The ravine marks the farthest I, or anyone I know of, has dared venture. Here are the coordinates. I will follow stealthed, using the dune's shadows.
Think first of your own safety, and do not follow if it becomes too harrowing.
Your concern is appreciated. Darth Barriss enlisted my services to be scout and lookout, and I intend to do my job. Head deeper into the desert, and you will find the Desert Wound Ravine. Safe journey.
This is either a mirage, or a trap set by a nasty underwater monster. Or both.
Take a good, long look, Lightweight. See the man you're supposed to be. I'm the embodiment of your true potential. I am what you could be if you had the guts to follow the dark path more faithfully.
I follow the path of my master and the Sith to the letter.
You cannot lie to yourself. Cease your merciful tendencies and embrace the full meaning of the dark side of the Force, or you will be destroyed.
Exactly how will I be destroyed?
There are any number of disasters you are flirting with. You are Sith. You walk among Sith. The stench of the light in you will be like rot in their nostrils. Darth Barriss will smell it on you and will strike you down without mercy.
He has yet to notice anything.
Do you really think he would tip his hand to you? See, that is where the light will truly fail you. The light blinds you to the ill will growing from your fellows. Barriss and the other Sith will have the advantage of deception. And the power of the strongest forces in the galaxy. Passion, rage, love. The light shuns and denies these things.
The light is a difficult path. I might want to rethink things.
Now you're coming around. Think this through. This Padawan Barriss wants you to kill can destroy him. He has seen it. What if you can seduce her? Claim this Padawan for yourself. Corrupt her to the dark, control her, and add her power to yours. A master of the dark side could turn this Padawan, and then you can destroy Barriss and claim everything he has.
I think there is merit to what you say.
Good. Embrace your dark destiny. Reverse the path you've been walking.
Yes, I dedicate myself to darkness.
Excellent. I commune with you now, and deliver you to the purity of the dark. Yes, you have opened yourself to your true destiny. Now we are one. In the clarity of this communion, a vision of our destiny on Tatooine appears. Can you see it too? An encampment hidden in the farthest reaches of the desert, past a rock formation called the Forbidden Pass.
Is this where I will find the Jedi Master Yornlok?
There is no doubt this is where the Padawan went. This is where the Great Master helped her powers become expressed. The image fades. Find the Forbidden Pass and confront Master Yornlok beyond it. Our journey on this planet ends there. Farewell.
I cannot believe what I just witnessed. Did you just tell yourself to venture beyond the Forbidden Pass?
That is my understanding.
I am chilled to the bone. The desert beyond the Forbidden Pass is an area that no one can survive. No one! Even the Sand People dare not go. You mustn't go!
The opposite is true. I must.
This is not some silly superstition! Those who go beyond the Forbidden Pass are never seen again. I will not. I cannot follow you there.
You've done enough, Shorik. Thank you.
That is kind of you to say. I told Lord Barriss I would see your mission through, but I never imagined it would come to this. With a heavy heart, I give you the location of the Forbidden Pass. I am shamed that my cowardice paralyzes me. I fear I will never see you again.
I'll be fine. I don't plan on dying in this desert.
If you plan to cross the Forbidden Pass, that is exactly what you are doing.